You guys have had so far?
Actually, on my first night here, I was helping do lines, and this one girl ran out. And I was like, come get your free photo taken. She was like, I peed myself. Where do I go?
What's your biggest scare that you've had?
People peeing themselves. Or running face first into a wall like I made somebody do last night.
They're cuties.
So these are the live rats that we put in the haunt behind safety glass. Not actually out in the haunt, except there's an actor who does hold a live rat in his hand, just like a live actor will hold a snake in their hands. So these little buggers are adorable, I think.
So tell me about the actors again.
So the actors, the way we have it here at Statesville is every year we hold audition just like any other haunted house. And every year we get the return of the veterans, and then every year we get new actors coming in. So we get new different personalities we can throw into the haunt, which I love. I think the 4 or 5 years I've been here, we've had different actors every year, but we've had the same vets every year, and the interaction between both groups is amazing. They both feed off of each other, and that's what really makes a haunted house, is the actors and the process and the energy they bring to each other and to the guests.
There's a particular type of person that you look for like working here? And
yes, yeah. Absolutely. You know, a lot of people think of the stereotype that I'm looking for big, scary dudes or hard asses, and I'm not. And I think that might come from my theater background as well. You know, what I'm looking for are people that don't mind looking ridiculous. What I'm looking for are people that want to do this, that have the heart to do it. Because at the end of the day, you're never getting paid enough to do this. I mean, you're talking hours inside of this space. And sometimes our customers are incredibly rude to us or violent. you know, and so if you don't love this, if you don't want to do it, you know, it's never going to work out for you. But beyond that drive, I want to do it. I need you to be okay with looking silly. Looking ridiculous, because if you take away all the walls and the lights and the costumes and the makeup, we all look really ridiculous jumping around in a field. So I need that mentality. I need that person that's willing to step over that line and you know, fly their freak flag. You know, get weird. That's what we're doing here.
The people. Oh my God, the people. I mean,
Absolutely. Without the zombie army crew, I don't think I'd be doing this, honestly. I mean, it's great, and we make money doing it, and it's a great gig, but if you take away the people, you know, the friends, the family, the team, if you take that away, there's very little reason for me to do this. I do it because this is the life I like to live. I like that I get to get up and go to work with creative, fun people, and we get to make, you know, new worlds. I love that I get to come here when all the kids are here, and the excitement on all those kids that they've got this, you know, this thing that they're so proud of, and they give their energy to, and that's infectious. You know, everyone kind of gets it. You get all kind of fuzzy in the kids. it's the people, man. I love the kids out here. I love. You know, my friends and family, you know, I get to work with my brothers, my mom, my dad. I can't ask for anything more than that. That's my favorite part, you know. And at the end of the day, you know, the reason I got into it is because I'm a theater guy. You know, at the end of the day, I'm a storyteller. And sure. I get to tell stories here, you know, and I got 150 little storytellers back there helping me tell my story and helping me alter it and enhance it and change it. So, you know, it's that mix of being able to be a storyteller at such a mass level where you're doing thousands of people a night to see your story and the people you get to tell that story with. It's really amazing.
Tell me about Statesville, John.
Statesville. What is to say about Statesville? Statesville is where I've spent the last 17 years of my professional career, that's for sure. I came on the scene in 1998. I was a college student down at Southern Illinois University doing theater, and I wrote a thesis on how a theater company can make money and create a new marketplace by doing haunted houses. Made sense to me. I mean, theater departments have costumers, lighting designers, set designers, actors, directors, everything's in-house. So I gathered up a bunch of my friends from college. We did one as a sample down in Carbondale and then came up here and I met Paul Siegel, the owner. And at the time, Paul was doing a haunted hayride and a little black maze walkthrough. So met him in a little restaurant, gave him my thesis idea, told him what I think I could do out here, and came out and took down what they were doing, a little black maze thing, and created what is now known as Statesville Haunted Prison.
Was there a reason why you picked Statesville out of other things? Was it local for you?
I mean, I can't really say I picked. You know, I was right out of college. I mean, I knew nothing.
Okay.
I luckily ran into Paul through a different person that I just started working with. I was doing events, so I was designing parties and festivals for another company, and they introduced me to Paul because they met him at a farmer's market. You know, it's just one of those things where everything just kind of came together. And what is really kind of neat is that my family lives just on the other side of the bridge in Lockport, nice. Illinois, and I graduated from Lockport just over the bridge. So in a way, it was very local. You know, my mom, my dad, my brothers, my sisters, they all live in the area. So it was really neat to come home from school and my first big project was right here, you know, in home territory.
Did you expect it to grow so much?
Did I what?
Did you expect it to grow so much?
Did I expect it to grow so much? No! No, man. I mean, first of all, it was 1998. You know, it was before the haunted house world had an industry. You know, there were only some people doing big haunts back then. You know, like the Joe Jensens of the world, you know, doing 80s. But it was very far and few between. You know, most haunted houses were little charity things, little fundraisers or park district haunts. So never did I imagine we'd be, you know, the number one viewed haunted house in Illinois for, you know, I think we've
many,
like,
many years.
Yeah, it's been like 15 years, I think, we've had the most attendance in anyone in the state of Illinois. So.
How many people come through your door?
Tens and tens of thousands.
That's fucking
awesome.
That's
all I can say about that. A lot of people. Brazilians and Brazilians.
How did you keep up with growth? Like, what were your challenges there?
You know, see, the challenge with the growth, because you don't really know what that top end is. You know, you have goals. Every year you want to do more people. Of course, it's business. But, you know, it's such a, for us, it was a very Wild West kind of mentality. You know, none of us, as much as we had theater background, we didn't have any haunted house background, really, except for doing a small one in the mall or some little ones I volunteered with when I was young. So, you know, we had to redesign on such a regular basis, you know, which actually worked out with our philosophy of our build season. You know, it's my philosophy that we should redesign, tear down 30 to 40% every single year. And the reason for that is we should be challenging ourselves to be better. You know, we should be challenging ourselves to be more innovative and cutting edge and to show the audience something they've never seen before. That's why they come to this. They come to enter another world so they can see things they've never seen. So because of that, because of the way we build, really worked hand in hand with being able to adapt to all the big numbers. You know, because it did, it changed from this small little show, you know, where it was me and a few of my college roommates and a handful of my nieces and nephews, cousins, brothers and sisters. My mom backstage and my dad tearing tickets.
Can't have the family.
You know, and back then we got to take a ton of time with customers because we didn't have any. And as we got more successful, we had to design a different type of show. It couldn't be those tight little quarter shows where you work with an audience in a room for a minute or two. I mean, that's great. I'd love to do that again. But you can't do that here. Here, so many people show up and you can't make them wait in line forever. So we have evolved our design into more of this visual spectacle interactive show. So you walk into these room designs. I call it the room within a room design. I started this like 6 years ago, where I designed these giant open rooms and then put smaller rooms inside of that giant room. So that way when customers do come in, we do have that time to play with them and work them in the theme, but we're always moving them and we're always giving them something to look at. So that way, you know, you don't want customers running into other groups, and you don't want customers waiting 4 hours in the tent either.
Sure.
So you're always trying to walk that line of creating an interactive show that is not just a collage of images, and at the same time moving them through fast enough that you don't piss them off by making them wait on the show. It's a balance. It's a balance.
What's the weirdest thing that you've seen here?
The weirdest thing that I see here? God. I mean, I see weird stuff every night. You know, reactions to being scared is interesting. I truly believe there needs to be a psychological study on haunted houses and its customers. In a good way, not a negative way, but it's fascinating to see people come and what they're willing to expose themselves to. You know, and so it's always fun to watch their reactions. You know, whether it's people just shutting down, going catatonic, or just passing out. You know, that's something we get a lot. People just pass out and fall down. That's a lot of fun.
I've seen a video where you guys had to cart somebody out on an ambulance, too.
We cart a lot of people out. Yeah, we get a lot of people passing out, so that's interesting.
Nice. And what, I don't know, big plans for next year. Are you planning already?
I already have plans for next year. The best time for me to design a haunted house is in October when it's running.
Okay.
I design for the customers. I'm designing for them. So when I follow them and I'm in costume, you know, playing the roles, I want to see what they're reacting to. You know, and what a customer reacted to a couple of years ago is not necessarily what they're going to react to this year. So you got to really play that balance as well. So I follow them through the haunt, and I know what's working and what's not working. And even if we thought it was a brilliant idea when we designed it and built it in the spring, doesn't necessarily mean it's going to work. So you got to be willing to kill your babies. Okay. It may have been your favorite room, but if the customer's not reacting to it, you kill it. You knock it down, you build something new. So next year, I'm going out to the Maniac Ward.
Oh, nice.
One of our most famous rooms. The audience loves it. The actors love it. But I think it's time we challenge ourselves to come up with something better. So I'm going after the Maniac Ward. I'm probably going after the Blood Room. I'm going after the Electrical Room. And I might be doing something with the Sisters Room.
Okay.
And I'm going to go over to City of the Dead. And I'm going to tear out the entire back half of the City of the Dead.
Nice.
So, yeah.
That's a lot of work. How long is that going to take you to do that?
That takes us about 6 months.
6 months.
Yep.
Okay. Do you have a large carpenter crew then? Or
no, we run with a crew about 10
okay.
12. Yep.
Okay. Well, that's about it, John.
All right, great.
Thank you very much.
No problem.
City authorities in your area have reported that the bodies of the dead are rising from their graves and attacking the living. Thank you.